I've been in love with you. Stronger than any mountain cathedral, truer than any tree above, deeper than any forest primeval. I've been in love with you. I'll send showers in the winter. You bring flowers in the spring. We'll fly through the fall and summers with love. The fire starts to mellow, burning lines in the book of our lives, through the binding cracks, and the pages start to yellow. I've been in love with you. I am in yellow. I've been in love with you. I am in love with you.
A small confession to make. You see, I'm a bit of a magic freak. You know when all that sewing women in half and putting people in boxes and making them disappear? Well, I just love all that. And that's why I'm really looking forward to meeting my next guest. Because when it comes to magic, believe me, he's the best there is. He started baffling audiences when he was still at school by multiplying billiard balls and swallowing goldfish. And he's been baffling them ever since. He calls himself the unusualist, but I call him just plain magic. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome Mr. Paul Daniels.
Thank you. Now I'd like you to enter the world of what we call close-up magic, where I... Hello, the new.
Oh.
You're supposed to be over there singing song, aren't you, Flower?
Well, I've got a bit of a frog.
That's not a bit of a frog, that's a bit of a butterfly. Now, I'll translate. She said she's got a little frog. A bit of a frog. You see, we have to have interpretation boards. This is the only show, folks, on the telly with subtitles. Right, frog removing outfit. Yes, we can do that for you, Lena. All things are possible in the world of magic. All you have to do is take a little seat. That's it. Did I tell you to sit on it?
No.
Okay, don't. You see, up north, Flower, you wait till fellas tell you.
Okay,
sit. Right. Now. Now. None of that women's lib stuff. It hasn't got up there yet. Now, this is a frog-removing outfit.
Oh.
A frog-removing outfit. It doesn't look like it. It looks like a sword, and it is. From... there you go. Do you remember them Roman epics the BBC used to do? This is from the props department. It's nice, isn't it?
Oh, no.
See that apple?
Yeah.
Watch very close. I shall prove to you how sharp this sword is. If I hit it, I'll probably miss. Core. Hey, that's very good, isn't it? I mean, look at that. Look how neatly I cut that apple in two. Look at it.
Lovely.
Oh, you pick it up and have a look. Isn't that good? Yes? Do you want to eat it?
Thank you.
No last request, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Because I haven't told you about this bit. Now, this bit is better than that bit. This is, what is this bit? This is the shackle. Okay? Now then. What's wrong with the apple?
Nothing, nothing.
Oh, it's your throat.
Throat.
You're worried about the throat?
Yeah.
Don't worry about the throat.
Okay.
I've got a system for you. Look, this is a shackle. I'll explain it all, because people always suspect it's a magician's prop. It was used for a slave trade job. You see, it's got one channel down there. Don't look so worried. Don't look so... Relax, relax, relax. Right. Now, this is where the blade goes down the channel there, down the channel there, down the channel there, down the channel there, and out of there, all right?
Yeah.
Perhaps I could demonstrate that to you in a manner that would prove there's only one entrance and one exit. If we take the sword out of here, like that, you can actually see it going through. I sincerely hope I can't hit the hole. There it is, you see? Look at that. All the way through and out there. The part that I find fascinating with this frog-removing outfit is this. You see, if you remove the sword, yeah, like so, and place it there, you will be able to open it up, put it down the throat. Now the frog is expecting a full frontal attack, all right? Had its holidays in Brighton. And what you do, you just tighten it like this, and we put that through there. This prevents the whole thing opening, okay? Now you hold it tight against your throat.
Yeah.
Now what the frog is watching for is an attack. This way, we do not go that way.
Right.
No. We sneak upon the frog from behind. Let me know if you feel this. You can.
Yes.
Well, don't worry. Acupuncture so far has worked for the Chinese. It shall now try to work for us. We'll just level that up a little bit like that. Now what's the matter with you?
Stepped on my foot.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's what I do. I step on the foot there very hard, then you know not feel the pain up here. So there she goes, all the way through. Where she finishes, nobody knows. Now the frog looking in the opposite direction. Get in there, fella. There it is. The frog is looking, and suddenly, one dead frog. All right? Now all you've got to worry about now is getting it out again. We're going to try and get it out again. What's the closing number?
I don't know.
You don't know? Oh, I'm not surprised at this stage of the game. It won't really matter because you're going to sing it with a sword through your neck anyway. Oh, no, she's not. We take that out of there. One complete sword there. We take the lock off there. Lena Zavaroni, you have been absolutely beautiful and to work with, and very, very brave, because I wouldn't put my neck in there.
You.
I know it can go wrong. There we are, ladies and gentlemen, Lena Zavaroni.
Amazing. I mean, I've been rehearsing with him all week and I still don't know how he does it. Anyway, also my many thanks to Robert White, and I'm really looking forward to seeing you all next week when my guest will be the 3 degrees. So until then, good night.